Russian Naval Shipyard, Kola Peninsula, Russia, January 26th, 2005. 2014 hours. Information collected at the Kola facility indicates that the cell operating under the command of Colonel Alekseevich has standing orders to capture a Russian submarine manufacturing facility on the Kola Peninsula. Third echelon monitoring reveals that the Russian nuclear submarine Vselka is currently docked at the facility. The submarine must be located, and Alekseevich's remaining men must be stopped. Sorry for the pretty sloppy reading.
We've updated your objectives. Your first target is a Russian sailor. We spotted him by drone. We think he's the only shipyard employee left alive.
What makes him so special that they let him live?
That's what we want you to find out.
So, greetings for the Oathlings. Welcome back to the penultimate episode of Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. This is, as you probably guessed from the title, a Russian submarine? No, wait, it's Vselka Infiltration. So basically, I couldn't help myself but toy with this level initially. And right after I played Kola Cell, I went around and toyed around this level initially. As you can see, we already have dogs here. So the only sure shot way I found of avoiding them, I probably could have done that from up there, but yeah, let's just take our time, no need to rush. So the only sure shot way of avoiding the dogs here is by grabbing onto the ledge, because the dogs in this game are dumb. They can sniff you out as long as you're on the ground, but as soon as you're hanging off the ledge, they've got no idea where you are. See, the dog has already picked up my scent, but he will be unable to tell where I am. Now, while this is more of an unintended consequence, you could have done without that as well, but it does play in our favor. Now, where we want to go is right up this, what do you call it? Container right here, and just jump up and grab it. As soon as you're up here, you're safe-ish, sort of. Thank you. And next step is to run up to this other container and again grab it. And yeah, then use the zip line to go over there, and then just climb through a window. And then I told myself, you know what? I'll just play it with my viewers. I need to stop now. Anyway, so moving on. It can be a little tricky sometimes because, as you can see, just jumping up here doesn't really do the trick. You need to run straight at the whole thing. Yeah. And we're in. That was how you play the first part. As for the rest, well, I guess I'll just see how to do it as I go along. So the problem here is that you've got a guard inside, and you don't exactly want to alert him to your presence. I'm just going to make a save here. So yeah, this guy out inside, you don't really want to make a lot of noise. Make sure that your footsteps are slow and deliberate. Who noticed me now? Who noticed me now? So yeah, you can practically get over to this corner here and sort of chill, I'm guessing. Let's see how it works out for us, because I've never tested this myself. But let us just hope that we can. Because there's really no option of closing this window. Not that this game really bothers you with that kind of stuff, but yeah. Just quietly follow him into that shadow over there, and we'll see what to do after that point in time. So we basically want to avoid being in the light around this camera, and yeah, so stick to the right hand corner when you can. It'll help you remain in the shadows, and I suppose that is that. Let me just quickly bring out my camera jammer and see where to go. There's already a dead guy there. Things don't exactly look good for us. Can't we just... Yeah, that would take more bullets. Let's see here. We can't exactly grab onto this pipe, can we? Things are vicious. Okay, let's try this again.
Hold out there.
Fine. Does this put us anywhere in the shadow? Because if it doesn't, then yeah. I mean, shooting out the light will not exactly work. Does it? It does. Hey, that's nice. I mean, if they're gonna come over to investigate, might as well just, you know, take the least noisiest path, even though, I mean, yeah. So let that guy just go away, and... That's good, that's good. You realized that all on your own. That's very good. And yeah, so I guess that's that. I'll just drop down here. Okay, so basically, as soon as you hear this guy peeing, just go ahead and grab onto the pipes again and start hanging. Let this guy come in, and then I guess we'll go ahead and do whatever we have to do. Let that guy do his business, then we'll do our business, basically. Seeing how things work in this game is actually a pretty difficult thing. That guy just clips through the control case and he does something with the turret. And he does something with the turret again. And is he just going to keep doing this? Because if he is, then I think I'm clear to proceed. So I was supposed. Now to stick the landing properly. Ah, masterfully done. It's locked again. It's odd how the first key you press isn't really, you know, the key which works. That was some glorious lag there. I don't know why my games have been lagging all so much these days. Anyway, so here we are. I wonder where to where we proceed next. At any moment now, once you stop lagging. And yeah. There's a tube light there. I wonder. It's probably that door, but doesn't really go to check the other ones, so does it? That one there is the toilet, so I doubt it would be that door. Seems like a dead guy and a computer in there. This is the toilet, so it can't be this door. The only door left is this one, unless we have to somehow get to the elevator. And there's a stairwell here. I can hear people moving about inside. So let me just get inside this corner here and make another save. Save number two. Is there somebody coming down? Sounds like a lot of people actually. Or maybe no, they're just patrolling around, who knows. I mean, I can't see anybody from here, so... Oh wait, there are people down there. Who exit this place. I suppose we should move further now?
That's exactly why I'm staying put.
You don't care about...
I don't care about anything but getting paid. Now I've gotten paid, I want to be around to spend the money.
Hey, man, I got nothing on you that you don't got on me.
Yeah, don't forget that.
Okay, is this the way? Certainly seems to be. And the camera only saw me there. Good thing I was in the competitive shit here. Huh. Let me just take cover here at this point. That did not work out as expected. Okay, let's try this again.
Eating like that, you are going to get fat.
I can't help myself. My own mother never cooked so well.
Maybe you didn't salt her well enough.
Be nice. Anyway, we need to get back to our patrol.
Relax. Nothing's going to happen. This is the easiest job we've ever had.
Us and our sailor friend both. But dinner is over. Come on, Arkady. Let's get back to our post.
Okay, so we just gotta... Okay, I suppose it was a good idea to wait for a while. Let's just keep moving here, I suppose. I'll just back off a little since the keypad code door is right here. So both of these things lead the same way. One is just more silent than the other, or so it would appear. Good. I probably should take these off, yes. I'm just going to pick up your satchel, sir. And, yeah. Wait, how do I open this door from the inside? Oh, fuck. Well, I did not expect that. Huh. You just bump into it. For a second there, I thought that maybe I was stuck. I guess this is the captive sailor that we were looking for, and yeah, let me just go ahead and quick save here in case, you know, something goes bad. I'll take out the light in case something goes bad and I need to escape. Anyway,
Babrav.
You're not one of them. Quickly, untie me.
No, but I do have a few questions.
You're not here to help me?
I'm not here at all. I can't take you with me, and if I untie you, it'll only mean trouble when the Spetsnaz finds you. I don't have much time, and I need to know why you're alive.
Oh, God!
They killed everybody but you. Why?
I'm a submariner. I operate the broadcast system on the Vselka. She's docked outside.
Broadcast system?
The submarine has a good communication system. Very flexible. The Azeris are using it to transmit signals north.
So how can I get at it?
You can't. Not now. They keep submarines submerged.
So how do you get at it?
We radio to the submarine from the compressor control room on the fourth floor. You need a passcode to get inside.
I'll bet you know that code.
Please, untie me.
I'm getting cranky, Bobrov.
The code is 8027.
Fisher, you're gonna need to get inside that sub.
I'm gonna need it to surface first.
We're working on it. I'll get back to you.
Okay, let me just get a few things equipped here, because I feel like, you know, firefight might just be around the corner, you never know. So anyway, with that being said, I'll just create another save here. Apparently that guy can't see you. So yeah, there's nobody outside here, you can just waltz right out. Nobody really cares. I guess the only way through is there.
They'll only have a few minutes to decide between surfacing or sinking to the bottom and suffocating. Details on your offset.
I don't think I'm going to be making any friends on this job.
No, I'm afraid, Fisher, you are not. So it's now up to you whether you want to continue or not. I mean, I know that you do continue since, you know, we've got six Splinter Cell games out already, but you get the point. So I'll just let this guy go away, I suppose, before I decide to head on down that path. Because this guy right there who can't see us apparently. So let me just go ahead and try making the run for it. And I'm assuming that this guy here comes someplace close. Actually, he doesn't, so we're pretty much clear to proceed along this path. Yeah, just make sure that guy isn't watching when you do. And there's also a camera here which we need to be aware of, which makes things extra complex. So, yeah. This seems to be a square corridor sort of thing, you know, like all routes lead to room sort of situation, so it doesn't really matter which road you take, you just need to get out of this complex. And yeah, just let this guy go, just make sure the camera isn't looking in your direction, and you can... break out my camera jammer. And I'll hurriedly walk up to this door. And I'll go upstairs instead. I hope this is not the way to go, but yeah. I'll just go upstairs nonetheless. For the sake of fun. Wait, do I see somebody roaming up there? Yeah, there is somebody roaming around up there. Wait a second, this is probably the way to go, isn't it? In the control room. Yeah, this is the way to go, actually. Fourth floor door code. Ah, yes, we do need to go up, actually. It's not somebody, it's just a fan, but yeah. There are people here. So I'll just create another save of, I suppose I'm in a safe spot, I don't really know. But in case I'm not, I do have my quick save to fall back on. So I'll just get to here, I suppose. Let me just make a quick save here. And so the door code was probably for this place. There does not really seem to be anybody here. Let me just take off my goggles. Trifocals. Trademark. By Sam Fisher. Let's see here. Nothing specific that I want to equip for now. Might come a time later when I would want to. What was the code again? 8027. 8027. So... basically, this was the piece of information that we got from... the guy that we knocked out. Okay. Do we want to follow that guy inside? Okay, we can't anymore. Maybe I'll try it again and be swifter this time around. Than I was right now anyway. Let's see if this door goes anywhere, since this is sort of like lockpicked, I'm guessing it does. Oh man, this guy literally turned to look at me back then. Bombed, which we haven't visited yet. And yeah, let him just turn about. Let me try. Moving into this corner here before the jammer runs out. Okay, so, excuse me, I'm just going to climb up over onto this bed here and probably lean against the wall, and hopefully you won't notice me, my good sir. You did not, just as I had hoped, and I will continue straight onwards to this crate here, which seems to be the only way forward, unless we follow that guy with the code.
GPS shows you within a stone's throw of the compressor. Get ready to move once you've thrown it. The men coming out of that sub aren't going to be happy.
You're underestimating my charm.
I'm just trying to fit in. Watch yourself.
Absolutely, Lambert. Absolutely. So it's saved in celebration of a well-completed section of the mission. Let's move forward. This does not seem to be a pretty safe spot for us. There's already a dead guy there. There's a laser over there. There's a laser. Low laser, high laser, I see. There are a few lights here. Alright, you know what? Yeah. Here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna start taking the lights out. because this does end up in a shootout, but fortunately those guys don't have night vision goggles. So this, and this, yeah. And it doesn't really make sense taking the rest of the lights out. I'm just gonna quick save here, and just look at all these vibrant and brilliant colors. Love them already. Anyway, moving back onto the mission at hand. Oh wait, the turret took a chunk of my health out. So yeah, basically the objective is right there. There's nobody here for the time being, but there soon will be. It's amazing how all the, you know, computers, important ones, are red in this game. Anyway, moving on. I guess we need to run for it.
We have an unauthorized presence in the compressor room. Send the team immediately. Intruder in the submarine compressor room.
Okay, yeah, there's a little bit of a wait out. You're practically sealed in here, you can't exactly go anywhere. Yeah, once they come in, that is the only time when you can go anywhere. And there are always three guys. One of these guys will just be standing right there, and one of these guys goes there, that way, one of these guys comes here. You just need to make sure that, you know, you...
Oh, what the hell?
Yeah, basically, yeah, this time he moved as well. I'm just gonna go back the same way I came, or maybe let me go ahead and try it this way. It does open. Hey, that's amazing. I hope I came in through the store here. Seems to be the store. It was nice. It's, you know, I sort of like it when the game gives you options to, when the game sort of, you know, gives you options to lose your, trackers, but, I wanna get up there. Can we get up there? Let me try. We can, actually. That is nice. I wonder where this takes us. If it does take us anywhere at all, it doesn't. That is sort of strange. But, hey, who am I to judge? Oh wait, there are people. People come upstairs. Person 1. And, person 2. Is there another person? Is there a third person? Third person would be Sam Fisher, but, yeah. Seems to not be the case. So, I'm just going to get inside here. Only job well done, you know. Since we did all that. And more. Can't we just drop down? Right here. That was a smooth drop. I would have been caught otherwise. Yeah, stables always make me sort of nervous, because you never know where they're going to come out from. And where they won't. I hear some people, I'm just going to crawl back into my little hole and stay here. Yeah, let's see here. Will they come here? I wonder. Yeah, fuck it, I'm just gonna risk it. No point in playing it like a pussy. There's nobody out here. Oh wait, that door is... That door is destroyed now and blocked by a huge chair. Oh wait, that's not a huge chair, that chair is just close to the camera. And I was like, wait, where did we get such a huge metal chair to block the entire door? I mean, why? Was it like faulty mechanism or something? Why did they have to go to those extents? Seems clear, for the most part. Back here, I suppose? Yep, there are people there. Sound is a pretty important factor in this game. You can hear footsteps and stuff. Just be careful when, you know, you move, and be aware of the sounds that are emanating from around you. Okay, so there are some people looking in my direction. Now I wonder how I take care of this scenario. Can I get out of this area as soon as possible without alerting them? Is there any light that I can take out here? No, not really. Probably what I should do is use a diversion camera here. Which, oh yeah, I do have a diversion camera here. So this guy, he looks in your direction, so you want to be sort of, you know. Yeah, and let's see how this guy reacts to that. And the way is now clear, I suppose. Of course, I'm not sure, but I suppose. Oh, that's that. Huh.
Fantastic work, Fisher.
Oh, this was a short level, short but entertaining nonetheless. I mean, it wasn't as long drawn out as the other levels. I guess that's why this was a bonus level, I suppose, you know, like what you would call a DLC today. But it's minus, you know, well, actually I take that back. DLCs today are like, you know, you get the game and then you get the rest. You know, you get like a demo version of the game with the DLC, and but not exactly a demo, and the actual missions are all in the... Wait, what did I say? I mean, you get like a demo version of the game with the game when you purchase the game itself, and the rest of the levels, the rest of the missions which actually matter are on the DLC. Yeah, not like that, but yeah, this is probably like a bonus mission. Short mission, not too bad. Pretty good, pretty entertaining actually. So basically thus far what happened was, let me just narrate to you the story because they aren't really doing much here. Sam intercepted, the third echelon rather, intercepted some signals from the Kola Peninsula in Russia, and they went ahead to check it out. It turns out Phillipe Masse was working there. The signature, the algorithms and stuff contained the signature, so Sam paid him a friendly visit to, you know, like get the algorithm which he used for the Georgian information crisis and get the location of the arc where the signals are being transmitted from, get more data about it and kill him. So yeah, so that, and when he gets that information from the Kola cell, Sam can now come over to Vselka and he can now infiltrate Vselka. I wonder, however, why they decided to make two missions out of this, seeing how the first mission was a little small, but yeah, going into Vselka, they've got a captured prisoner. I mean, the Russians were sort of, you know, going around capturing places and stuff, and the Vselka submarine base was one of them. The submarine base was one of them, and as it turns out, they had also captured a submarine named Vselka, which they were using for communications. And we just got to knock the submarine out and proceed further with our lives. And that's it. I guess the next mission will be in the submarine. I've played the Pandora Tomorrow submarine mission. That was, well, a little claustrophobic. In this game, I don't really know how it's going to be for this game. Maybe it'll be better. Maybe the submarine will be broader, or maybe it'll be just as narrow. But if it is as narrow, given the trend of this game, how the AI works and stuff, I don't really have much faith in it, to be honest. And yeah, anyway, that's it for today. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow things.